Good morning. It's Tuesday, March 31st, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled Remembering, and our scripture is Ephesians chapter 2. Paul writes, "Once you were dead because of your disobedience and your many sins. You used to live in sin just like the rest of the world, obeying the devil, the commander of the powers in the unseen world. He is the spirit at work in the hearts of those who refuse to obey God. All of us used to live that way, following the passionate desires and inclinations of our sinful nature. By our very nature, we were subject to God's anger just like everyone else. But God is so rich in mercy, and He loved us so much that even though we were dead because of our sins, He gave us life when He raised Christ from the dead. It is only by God's grace that you have been saved. For He raised us from the dead along with Christ and seated us with Him in the heavenly realms because we are united with Christ Jesus. So God can point to us in all future ages as examples of the incredible wealth of His grace and kindness toward us, as shown in all He has done for us who are united with Christ Jesus. God saved you by His grace when you believed, and you can't take credit for this. It is a gift from God. Salvation is not a reward for the good things we have done, so none of us can boast about it. For we are God's masterpiece. He has created us anew in Christ Jesus, so we can do the good things He planned for us long ago." Particularly among evangelicals, the last few verses of this text gets the press. Grace alone was the main thrust of Martin Luther's Reformation. And while there's no argument on my part that God's grace deserves first seat in Christian doctrine and practice, I have a high place in my heart and mind for resurrection, both from the grave and from the death of what used to be. The gist of that to which I'm pointing is similar to the history my bride and I share. We've been married a long time. Occasionally, we'll just sit together with almost no conversation. Inevitably, one of us will begin to marvel aloud at the history we have together and how God has led us through so much. The marvelous part of it is how we both understand we'd never be on this end of our journey, still together and still wanting to be together, had it not been for the grace of God providing some pretty awesome strength for that journey, especially during the lean and difficult years. Life can and does test any marriage up to and beyond the breaking point. Grace enters this conversation Elizabeth and I have about our history because we both understand the power that has seen us through many dangers, toils, and snares is the undeserved but unreserved kindness and mercy of God in Christ Jesus. It's that power which holds all things together, from the molecules He first created eons ago and then reformed from chaos into the wondrous order of all we see in the earth and the universe, all the way to the forces, events, and even thoughts in our minds. It is prevenient, provident, and beneficent grace that God bestows upon us. Our lives, even the next breath you take, are an impossibility except for the hand of Jesus Christ. I see that in the same way the Apostle Paul wrote about it. Everything was created through Him and for Him. He existed before anything else, and He holds all creation together. For you today, take it from a genetic introvert. While you're stuck at home, it's a blessing you'll not regret to look back and see how God has held you together through life. Take a little time today to thank Him for where He's got you right now. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.